Hello guys, today I will be playing You Will Not Remain. You Will Not Remain is, you can get it on Steam and stuff. Okay, let's begin. This game was made on the land of the Wurundjeri Woiwurrung. People of the Kulin Nation, we pay our respects to the elders past, present, and emerging. Sovereignty was never ceded. Colonial violence never stopped. You Will Not Remain is a story about isolation that contains dark themes and deals with mental issues. These include, are not limited to anxiety, depression, dissociation, and suicidal ideation. Okay. Let's start. You Will Not Remain as a... Yeah, okay. Supposed to be played in one sitting. It's time to wake up. Again, how many more agains will you have? How long have you been here? Does it matter? Okay. So, I think I'm gonna go out if I can. Leaves are dropping. You should water it. Fill the watering can and take it to the plants. You soak the base, hoping it's both enough and not too much at the same time. You've never been good with plants, and sometimes trying too hard is what kills them. Okay. So, I'm gonna go to the TV. Channel after channel of nothing. Okay. Oh. How about... no, I can't leave. Okay. I don't know what that is, but yeah, I think I'll go back inside. I'm not sure if I can go somewhere else. You still have plenty of grounds, an instant when you're desperate. You haven't even gone through all the apartments on the floor. Making it is as much a ritual as it is comforting. You cradle the cup in your hands, warmth seeping in your fingertips. That's oddly a lot of detail. Grow was cold and you stare at the sink. The ceiling, the strange shapes your hands make around the porcelain. Pour it down the sink, wash the cup before putting it away. Maybe tomorrow will be easier. Oh, well, that was embarrassing, to say the least. It is getting bigger, or was it always that size? If you were prone to poetry, you'd almost say it was beautiful enough. Fatalistic sort of way, but you're not. Haven't been for some time. You've run out of pretty metaphors for awful things. That's kinda deep. There's not much else to do. You could walk in circles around the apartment, or you could go back to bed. Bark, bark. Is that a dog? Impossible. It's been weeks since you've been stuck here. But I've surely heard it before this. Bark, bark, bark. Howl. Okay. You better go see what it is, just in case. Come on, open the door. You know you can. Can't you? You can do this. Come on. Like saying the words will help. That dog's howling too much. Come on. Finally. It's wrong. Everything is wrong. You don't belong here. If you need to get back inside. Oh, no. No. Why can't I walk? Oh. It's only down the hall. You can do this. Is it coming from there? I'm not sure. Yeah, I think it's definitely in the dog's definitely in there. Is something wrong with this apartment? Hey, puppy dog. Yes, it is a dog. But it doesn't look like any dog you've seen before. It's thin, skin stretched tight across ribs, long body, all bones, and hard angles. Why is this game so descriptive? It's okay, I'm not here to hurt you. Bark. That's right, everything is okay. Want to come with me? I can't whine in dog language. Okay, whine. Then I'll just say the word. Is that a yes? The dog jumps forward before you can react. Brace for pain, and instead feel the drag of its tongue across your chin. It pants happily as it tries to lick every inch of your face. Oh. Oh, okay. Whoa, down. It drops all to all fours, looking obediently up at you, tongue lolling out of a mouth bisected by wickedly sharp teeth. I mean, it's an alien dog, but it's still a dog. Glad to leave. Something is wrong here. A new kind of emptiness. Come on, you just found a dog, and this is your reaction? No bed, no chairs, no life. How did the dog even get here? When the two of you leave, it will be like nothing has ever been here at all. Dog follows at your heels, nose sniffing furiously at the air. Bark? Just a little further. Okay. Wait a minute. Oh no, I can't leave it. The dog runs ahead of you, tail wagging. So hard it makes a loud thump when it slaps the wall. Glad to see you like it. Okay. Now we have a dog. Okay, I think I can pick up a bone or something. This is enough excitement for one day. It's time to go to sleep. Arf, bed. Okay. I guess you're sleeping with me. You peel back at the covers and slide into the bed. The dog is warm, rolling up. You can okay. When you settle into the sheets and it is across your neck, warmth metal like breath lulling you to sleep. Oh, where am I? Okay. Dreaming. You remember being worried about her. You remember waiting anxiously at the door. You remember how the apartment still smelled of her for weeks, the sweetness of her who? They don't smell like her anymore. That's weird. It's a dream, if only things were that easy. Oh. Well. What? No. He stay. No. We can't do this again. Don't think about it, it's like it'll it never happened. Stay inside. Please, no. The puppy dog is waking me up. Mm-hmm. Bark. That's certainly one way to be woken up. You can't complain though. Not when it saved you from... Bark, bark. Right, you have a dog now. A very strange looking dog. Water of a plant. Has it gotten bigger? It's not dead. Maybe that means something. That I'm good at gardening. Yeah, I guess. Need to do something here. But I don't know what. It's purple, so I have to do something. I have another theory. Maybe this is just nuclear fallout. That's purple for some reason. Oh, who's that in the distance? It's probably not intended to be there. Okay. And so I can't do anything here. I think I need to do something inside. Oh, is that hue changed? Aha. You make coffee, just like every other morning. You cradle the cup in your hands. Yeah, I already know that. Just like every other morning. But this time, something is different. The dog is here. Looking more at home than you've ever felt. Yeah, that's basically what dogs do. The coffee is cold, but you drink it anyway. Bitter all the way down. Bark. Are you hungry? Bark, bark. We're lucky that we don't have any neighbors. Well, I don't think you're alone here. Okay, now I can go. Nah, I have to do something inside. You fed the dog? No, there has to be something purple. Wait a minute. Let me check the thing. Oh! When you set it down, the dog lunges desperately towards the food. Munch, munch. It's eating so fast you barely see it chew. Better not throw that up. Okay, I think I have to get the coffee, and then I can go out. Well, you fed the dog, may as well feed yourself. You'll cook with whatever you can find, thankful for electric stove top. Wait a minute. Where does this guy get his food? Never mind. You eat from the pan, standing over the stove. No one's here to judge you. Bark. You've already fed up the dog. What do they want? Bark, bark. Okay. I'll go near the dog. Wine. Oh, that's not a wise choice of drinks, my friend. You want to leave? Bark. Okay, you're the boss. I'll leave with the dog. It's easier to manage terror that climbs up your spine when the dog is so happy to be outside. Where are we going? Bark! Hold your horses. Okay, now we can explore the other part of the apartment. What's that? It looked like servers for a second there. You've never been up here. Barf. Oh, that's. It's. You're worried if you stare too long, you might fall in. Bark. The dog stares at you, imploring for a moment. Its eyes flash violet. No, you're imagining things. It's just a dog. It's not just a dog. I mean, it is just a dog, but. Oh, whatever. Let's go! You can almost ignore the lilac glow when you're playing fetch. Forget for a moment that vast, out otherworldly thing stretching through the sky. Okay. I'm gonna play ball with this dog for a while. Why not? You're a good boy. The dog doesn't seem worried about it. What time is it? Noon? Evening? Probably mid-late. At least one of them, maybe even all of them. I mean, didn't you just say it was morning? Oh, whatever. Who's your good boy? You sure? What, Paul? Yes. I think that's enough for one day. We can come back tomorrow. Bark. No, it's not enough. Why can't I throw the freaking ball? No. Stop it. I guess I can't throw the ball anymore. Let me see. Okay. So I have to go. Someone's in a rush. Okay. I kinda wonder, how can we, go to the exit? It didn't take long to figure out home. The dog looks proud of itself. Okay then. We're so tired. When was the last time your lungs has tasted fresh air? You can't remember. I'm sorry, I think that's all. All I have for today. Wine. I guess this is my life now. I wonder how they get food. Do they just eat? I'm still not sure. But it's okay. This game's kinda comforting. You crawl under the covers. You still haven't washed them. Not since. The dog lays atop of you, heavier than expected, seeing as its skin and bone. It cuddles into you, knife-long teeth, a whisper from your throat. You can feel its heartbeat through the blanket. Oh, that's a lot of detail. Okay. Now I'm here again. You wish this was over. I think I'm gonna go here again. Sit, stay inside. If you don't let them, they can't get inside. Silence, no sound, no thoughts. You type in her number into your phone. You know it was off by heart. The sound of the buttons are a familiar melody. Ring, ring. It rings out. Try again, and again, and again. Ring, ring. Nothing. Miles and miles of nothing. Maybe she's fine. You try to convince yourself. Don't let anyone in. That if they're not inside, she has to be inside. Maybe already downstairs. Just in time. Just in time. Okay. Okay, I'm up. Bark. Okay, I think I will do my morning routine. When you touch the soil, it's bone dry. Like it's always thirsty, and it's so deep it wouldn't be slacked by any ocean. You used to know something about need. Now, you won't let yourself remember what it means to need anything, let alone want it. That's kind of deep for watering a plant. First things first, coffee. You make it. Hold the cup until the liquid cools. Look down at it, foreign in your unfamiliar hands. You pour it down the sink. You win some, you lose some. Was that about, pouring coffee into the sink? Bark. Okay. Wait, I thought the coffee mug was eyes. Well, I guess it's not. Okay. I think I have to do the same thing. Here you go. Excuse me for a moment. Don't know why. Munch Munch are slowly getting used to living with the dog. How long has it been now? You can't remember. You should probably name them. Wait a minute. I thought it was just a puppy dog. It's fine. What's your name? You can't keep calling them dog after all. Bark. That's very helpful. How about Rex? Wine. Marble. Wine. Marble sink. Okay. I think we should just call it dog. I mean, there's not another dog here, so there won't be any confusion. Gas stove. Those are kinda dry names. Okay, Shank, there we go. Bark. Lampshank. Bark. Lampshank, really? Bark. Okay, that's going on for too long. Alright, you're the boss. The newly named Lampshank looks absurdly pleased with himself. Okay. Fine. Okay. Bark. Nothing has changed. The sky is... It's there. Don't think about it. Yeah, this game's kinda deep. How long has it been since you became stuck here? Someone could tell you it had been weeks, months, or years, and you'd believe them. It's not like you can see the sun anymore. Sometimes you forget what other people look like, the way their skin feels, how the muscles in their backs shift when you hold them. The thought of touching someone makes your skin crawl. You feel claustrophobic and desperate at the same time. Wrong. Okay. That's enough. Time to go back. Bark. I'm not sure if I'm gonna upload this, but oh well. Yep, I still need to do stuff. Should eat something, but maybe you shouldn't. You only ate 5 minutes ago, right? Or was it 5 days? This guy has a big disorientation of time. You think I should eat Lamb Shank? Bark. Okay, good call. You cook a meal of whatever you can find and eat it over stovetop. Howl. I'm coming. You and Lamp Shank are used to this dance by now. You settle in together and drift to. You'd do anything to wake up, but that isn't how it works. You don't look at the sky. The sky? What's wrong with the sky? What could possibly happen to the sky? That's it's how it hurts to look at it. It's wrong, not made for this world, but somehow captivating all the same. But why? Maybe you're imagining things. It must be. This isn't real. This can't be real. A fever dream, surely. If you go back inside, the world will return to normal. It has to. She'll come home, and everything will be the way it always was. Yeah, no, I don't. I'm not sure about that. I don't think so. Bzzzt. How about... want to think of who you used to be. What you were outside of the walls. As there is nothing left to think about. Interesting. Bark. It is becoming a cycle. Bark. Sometimes you think about going outside and being done with all it all finished. Okay. But you have Lampshack now. Yeah? I mean, dogs do be good. You won't walk down the stairs and pry the boarded doors open. Fingernails catching on wood, and nails as you claw yourself out. Oh. That's... Okay, let's just, move on. No, we'll stay here. That's a bit too deep for, playing fetch with a dog. For however long that is. Time to go, Lampshack. Bark. Gotta get up there for a thumbnail. Yeah. Bark. Time for bed. Yep. Oh, that's a new sound. Huh, that's weird. You can hear something. Hello? What? Is anyone there? No, you're imagining things. It's not possible. It can't be. Wine. Hey, it's okay. I'm okay. Are you? Lamprecht's eyes are wide. Body trembling above yours, scared. You've never seen him like this before. Does the radio frighten him? Everything feels so fuzzy. You pet Lampshack, running your fingers down his spine. Each vertebrae sharp against them. We're so tired. What should you do? This is your public service announcement. The people from outside are marked. They can only get in if you let them in. I cannot stress this enough. Do not let her in. She will hurt you. Please let me in. She's here. She's safe. She's... Do not let them in. They will hurt you. is something mental. Please, babe, let me in. I'm scared. We repeat, they will hurt you. They're at the door, unable to open it. Heart beating so hard you can taste the blood in the your throat. Oh, that's awfully sinister. You want to let her in, you do, but nothing feels real. Everything feels real. You try to move and open the door, but your body isn't responding. It's like watching someone else. Like you're no longer there. You're watching yourself like someone else would watch you. Babe, please, I'm so scared. So are you. White noise. You'd let her in, if you wanted to. Not safe. The screaming starts. You are brittle, and this is what breaks you. I'm up, Lampshank. I'm up. Is anything real? Is anything real? You water the plant just in case. Okay. Is anything real? Bark, bark. Real or not, you need to feed Lampshank. Not right now, I am going to look here. Was anything real? Is anything real? Okay, that question. What? Why is it always appearing? You fill up the food bowl. Munch, munch. Okay, let's go. Howl. Is anything real? Bark. No, there's nothing over there. Bark. If this is real, does it mean anything? Yes, my friend. Playing fetch with his puppy dog. And what's worse is that this isn't real. That it is, and means nothing at all. You can't even remember what she looked like, how she smelled. I can't recall how she fit within the spaces. Time to go, Lampshank. Bark. Okay. So, don't have a lot EX or anything. I think I have to go back to the dream. But just in case, I'll check the exit again. It's been so long that things you used to miss have become lost. You try to remember the shape of them, but over time, the image becomes softer and softer, washed away like regrets in the rain. But still, you try to picture the warmth of the world, of her, even through each time it gets harder and harder, like tonguing a sore in your mouth.